Vive le français! Bonjour les amis, je suis dans la cuisine et aujourd'hui je veux vous montrer des produits français typiques. So today I'm in the kitchen, I want to show you some typical French products. Je veux vous montrer la confiture. Okay? La confiture in English we'll say the jam. So my mother told me when she was a kid, something that the parents will do, and I think all the French family will do this, they will get all these fruits that you get for free from the trees in the countryside. And then they will make some jam, in big quantity of jam. And something about France is we have many fruit trees. Unfortunately, with the globalization, most of the farmers left. We have only 1% farmers left in France, and people move to the big cities. So now people don't do the jam by themselves. They just buy it from the supermarket, and the taste is not at all the same. Traditionally, the best jam, you will take the fruit that are very ripe, you will use the brown sugar with it, and you will do it inside a big bowl, but it's made of, there's none here. Anyway, so the jam, when you buy it, my advice is check the percentage of the fruit. So this one is 65% de fruits. This one, c'est la confiture de quoi? This one is la confiture de fraises. This one is la confiture de griotte. Griotte is the small cherry. La confiture de griotte. Let me open it for you. It's not open, so it's not open. La confiture de coin. Le coin is the kind of prune. La confiture de coin. And this one is la confiture de myrtille. La confiture de myrtille. Okay. La confiture de myrtille. I should not have opened it, in fact. La confiture de myrtille. This one is 65%. So you really need to look at the percentage. What's the percentage of fruits that you have inside, okay? What else do we have here? So la confiture, and nous avons ici aussi le miel. Le miel. Le miel is also something, a product that's quite, that's traditional in France. The honey. We have many different types of honey. This one, c'est du miel de tilleul. Du miel de tilleul. Tilleul is a tree. And here you have another honey. It's miel de châtaignier. Châtaignier. So the color of the honey is defined by the what kind of tree. Je préfère le miel de châtaignier. Je trouve que le miel de châtaignier est excellent. Le miel de tilleul is not as good. Le miel de tilleul is not as good. It just depends on your taste. So again, you need to be wary. I would recommend not to buy the Chinese honey sometimes because there are many fakes. And you can never know if you are eating the real or the fake. Even in France, you have some fake honey, but the control are very strict. And sometimes if you do the fake honey, you could end up in jail or at least with a big fine. So that's the thing. Donc la confiture et le miel. If you have the chance, maybe I will show you on the video, we'll cook together la confiture. On va faire la confiture ensemble, the traditional way. Okay. Merci les amis, au revoir. So you see, for instance, we have all these that we got from our garden, and many, many more. That's just, we cannot eat, so they're rotten away outside. The only way to can eat this is either to do la confiture, faire de la confiture, or you can do faire les compotes. Les compotes is similar to confiture, it's just you heat them with water and sugar. Faire des compotes ou faire de la confiture. Or you can try and wait and try to eat as much as you can. That's also a traditional way to keep for winter. Les confitures, on les mange en hiver. The jam, you will eat them during winter.